And finally, Joan and Jim's wedding. Action.
It's a lovely little church. It's the first time in the 9 series that we've had all the main characters together in one scene, so it almost feels like a real wedding. Everyone's so excited to see each other, there's not much acting required.
It's quite overwhelming having this many people here, not just our core cast, but all our supporting artists. You can't help but get a sense of a big occasion.
I think Jim is a good soul and a good heart, and she's made the right choice.
It's lovely to have the wedding, and it's going to juxtapose brilliantly, I think, with where Endeavour is, who's not turned up, who's having a rather difficult time.
Morse with you. He's not coming.
It's really, really great reuniting with the Endeavour world, with all the cast, with all the characters.
He's got the ring.
I've got the ring.
Kill him, where is he?
And I always felt like Jake's business in the world wasn't quite done.
Charlie Mark. Please be seated. Who gives this woman in marriage to this man?
I do.
Looking at the bride, looking at the groom, looking around, it's lovely, the loveliest, loveliest couple you've ever seen in your life, lovely.
I, Joan Thursday, take you, James Strange, to be my lawful wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do us part.
I, James Strange, take you, Joan Thursday, to be my lawful wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do us part.
I actually did feel like it was like a real wedding. I found myself kind of getting those kind of bride jitters as well, and then seeing him well up, I was like, oh, don't, you're going to set me off.
Cut there. Thank you.
Oh.
Cut there. I kind of think of my own wedding and being incredibly nervous, trying to remember the words. More so when a camera's pointing at you as well. And I probably had one too many coffees this morning as well, so I was quite jittery, but that was helpful.
You may now kiss the bride.
And we've all been getting quite emotional, myself in particular. Yes, I've been welling up.
It was very moving, actually. It made me think of Reggie's wedding day.
Was it an emotional point for you, Roger? You know, you played this...
Giving away my daughter, you know, in marriage. It is for any father, I imagine. So, yes, it was. And also, worried about where's Morse, you know, who's meant to be best man, for goodness sake.
It was just lovely, and then to come down and see all the faces in the crowd, felt quite emotional.
Lovely to be able to hang out with everyone all day. Everyone's dressed up in their best, and it's just we're having a lot of fun.
We see each other in the makeup truck or sort of, you know, readings and all the rest of it, but actually being on set is
it's lovely energy.
Look at this.
Costume, they've surpassed
themselves. They're all made specifically for us. I can't believe it. It's beautiful, isn't it?
When I did my final fitting, I just put it on and I thought, that's Joan's dress. It took my breath away. It's just perfection. It's because it's simple, but it's got, like, you know, a bit of life to it, and a bit of lace, and then the lace insert to go with the wide sleeves. So it was all made for the show, a collaboration between me and the amazing Ailsa, who is our costume designer.
Yeah, it's gorgeous. I mean, Joan looks wonderful. They're just playing it beautifully. I was welling up behind the monitor, despite us doing it 1,000 times.
And it was heartbreakingly gorgeous, and they did it really well. My children haven't got married yet, so I haven't had that pleasure, but I mean, oh my God, it felt like it, because I've known Sarah for 10 years, and she's been my daughter in the show, and I love her to bits. And so it was so beautiful to see her walking down the aisle with the great Jim Strange. He's a safe bet. It might sound boring, but Wynne's practical, and she wants her to have someone who will look after and take care of her and love her, and I think that he will do that for her.
For better, for worse.
We all thought it would be Endeavour, but I think she assures me it is love, so, yeah, I've got to take her word for it.
And he makes me feel safe.
My tin hat made me feel safe, but that wasn't love. I've seen how short life can be, Journey. Don't waste a second on regret.
Feeling an atmosphere beneath this series is you think you've got the rest of your life, and you haven't. Do you know, you think everything goes on and there's always an opportunity, and the reality is there's not. All things come to an end.
Oh. Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
But who's the lucky man?
This great loyalty that he has for Thursday, he also has for Strange as well, so how can I possibly sacrifice my friend's happiness for the potential happiness of myself? We see things skewed largely through Endeavour's eyes. Now, what if Joan never felt the same?
There has been a real sense of people wanting us to get together, but that's good. That's testament to the chemistry and the fact that we've managed to keep that going for so long, that will they, won't they, and, you know, it's been very cleverly crafted by Russell.
Miss Thursday?
We never had that drink.
No, we never did.
You want to have that feeling that Endeavour and Joan just missed each other, and you still want that to happen, but I think that we've managed to strike a good balance of making it feel like this is the right move for Joan.
Excuse me, was there a brunette here? Blue eyes. Yeah, she left the
bar. Sad thing is it's all about timing, these things, and you want to meet your partner and start the journey as a married woman and having children and all the rest of it, and I don't think she felt that she could wait forever.
And the window is just closed. He's waited too long. He's thought about it too much instead of acting.
Endeavour's gone on his journey and he's maintained his true self in that he is wedded to his work. What Strange offers Joan is something that's comfortable and safe and loving and supportive, and she loves him for that. The complications that Morse carries with him just couldn't have given them the happy ending. Morse has to see he's got to continue on his path. He has to go to his darkest place and then choose to carry on.
I think Jim and Joan do love each other, and I think hopefully that shines through.
I think that one of the things that has been most refreshing for Joan is that someone is putting his cards on the table and saying, I love you, I'm here, I'm ready and waiting, and I think she feels his intentions are totally pure. He dotes on her and she's just, you know, smitten and happy to kind of go down that road and think, yeah, this is my path, this is perfect, this is exactly how it was supposed to be. And then, you know, they drive away and you know, into their future. Tin cans rattling down the street.
I mean, Thursday and Morse, of course, is the couple of the series. We're working a lot on the tone of those scenes, and I hope we'll do that justice. Obviously, Roger and Sean will, because they're always absolutely on it. They know their characters so well. That'll be sad, saying goodbye to characters that we know and love so well and that feel such a part of it. I mean, I wasn't going to let anyone else do the final episode, having done the final episode of the last two series.
And is this a fitting end for the series, do you think? A church, a wedding, a graveyard. It doesn't get more apt, really.
And it's just almost been like an end-of-show party here today.
I know. Look,
I've worn this because it was a wedding today. I was like, I have to put a bit of colour on. So it has felt a bit like that.
It's just wonderful. And being around with everybody, it's been great.
And even yesterday, it felt quite emotional. Everyone was kind of on the edge as well. Because yesterday we were filming the reception and the party.
For some of the cast, this might be the last time we all see each other in the context of working on this show.
When you come back together, it's like a family. So
it is, yes.
You get very close over an intense period of time, and then you all go, whoosh, and you get used to that.
You'll keep in touch, won't you?
No.
No, not at all.
Not at all.
No. I've given him a phone number, but it's a false one.
I am gutted to say goodbye. I mean, everything, you know, obviously has to come to an end, but it won't be the same cocktail. It won't ever be this, and that's what makes it so special.
Such an extraordinary, beautiful bunch of really dedicated fans. The way that people have taken these characters to their hearts is testament to this world that everyone has created together.
It's bittersweet. I think we all feel sad that the show's coming to an end, but also very grateful for having been a part of it.
I feel very proud of the work that we've all done. I'm very privileged to have been a part of it, but I know that the time has come now for new adventures for us all, you know.
And that's a wrap.